All right, so you guys already know that my go-to shorts for the gym are the Lululemon Surge shorts. However, I've also been wearing these as just my go-to, you know, just out and about shorts. The only problem is that the only pockets they have is this like little back, little pouch where you put your keys when you go running. But also, even if I am wearing shorts or jeans with pockets, I just don't like having a lot of shit inside of my pockets, especially because I wear borderline women's pants. There's nothing wrong with that. But anyways, that's why I picked up this bad boy over here. This is the On The Belt bag from Lululemon. It's got a 4.5 liter capacity and it's got three main compartments. It's got one pocket close to the body, the main pouch, which has a little inner sleeve, as well as the outer pouch. So yeah, today I'm gonna be sharing with you guys my everyday carries, as well as what I have inside of my fanny pack. All right, so starting with the first pocket that's closest to my body, I have, of course, my wallet. Now, this is just a simple card holder from Coach that I've been using for at least 6 or 7 years. It's very, very slim, as you guys can see. It's just a card holder. I don't carry any cash with me. It's a bifold design. It's got two slots in here, as well as like a clear slot over here for my ID. And I just carry around my ID, two credit cards, a transit card, my debit card, and that's it. So if you're still one of those people, especially guys who have those like thick, massive wallets, because we all know you're not carrying around that much cash. It's just like filled with receipts, business cards, and just useless things. Really just try to go through your wallet and see which cards you actually use. If you need to get a money clip because you do carry around a lot of cash, do that. But yeah, just declutter your wallet, especially if you are sitting on your wallet and it's like this thick. That is a no-go for your spine. So definitely declutter your wallet. But this is a card holder that I've been using for many, many years. It's holding up really, really great. And I really like it. And then also in that compartment, I just got my house keys. So my house keys, as well as my mailbox keys. This little Moto thing is a car share program. So I left my car in Alberta, so I don't have a vehicle in BC. But BC has a ton of like car sharing programs. So Moto is one. I also have an Evo membership. So I don't know, BC is very car share friendly. So this is what I have, as well as the key to my electric scooter to turn that on. And then the lock for my electric scooter. And those are my very simple keys. So these two things go in the very back compartment. Next up, we're gonna be going into the main compartment. Obviously, we have the cellular device. I get a lot of questions asking which phone I use. This is the iPhone 8 Plus. I've had it for at least three or four years. And the reason why I haven't upgraded is because I don't really need to. Like, it does everything perfectly fine. The only issue that I'm having now is that because it's such an old phone and the lithium ion battery is only good for so many charges, the phone really only lasts half a day. And that is a problem because I work from my phone quite a lot. And I know people are gonna say, Joe, just get the battery changed. However, if I take this case off, I don't know if you guys can really see it, but the back of my phone is actually shattered. I have like a D-brand sticker on there so it doesn't like fall apart anymore. So if I were to get the battery replaced, then I'd also have to get the back glass replaced, and then I just don't think it's worth it at that point. So I'll probably end up just upgrading come September or October, whenever the phone comes out. But thankfully now, I think more people are realizing that they don't necessarily have to upgrade their phone every single year. I know when the iPhones initially came out, I was still part of the people who were like, oh, I need to get the latest and greatest. But then now people realize that like, hey, my phone is still functional. It's great. It's fast. I don't experience any problems with it. Why upgrade? Next up in the main compartment, I got my reusable mask. Make sure you guys are using a reusable mask. And then also in the main compartment, there's that little sleeve, that little pouch. So I've got my AirPods, my Flex Pods, you know, just pop these in, close some deals. And then next, I got me some lip balm. This is actually in a compostable, like cardboard packaging. Basically, the top just comes off like this. This is just cardboard. You push it up, and then you're good to go. I saw a thing where it was like, why do every guys apply lip balm like this? And it's so true. But yeah, I was just really thinking about how many little plastic, you know, lip balm or chapstick tubes that I've been going through in my lifetime. And it's just like, it's a lot. And just going back to my channel motto of being less shitty, especially when I do have access to, you know, lip balm or products in compostable packaging and have the means to do it, you know, why not? It's about making the small changes that are available to you at your current state that end up making a big difference. It is a little bit more expensive than what you would normally get at the drugstore. I think I paid $6 Canadian, which is like $4 USD, but it's made here in Vancouver from a local company. And I'm more than happy to support them, especially because, you know, it's in a little cardboard packaging. But anyways, there is that. The next one I'm super excited to share because it is a bar cologne. You just like slide it down like this, you rub your fingers in it, put them on your neck, put it on your wrist, and that's it. I go through like waves of whether I want to smell nice or whether I want to smell like nothing. And I just always found that actual like spray bottle colognes were either like too strong or too fragrant. And I just didn't want it to be that strong. Even when I wanted like a little bit, even if you do like one squirt and put it everywhere on your body, sometimes I found that to be too overpowering. And then when you look at it from an eco-friendly perspective, you know, it comes in plastic packaging, the little tube inside of the cologne is plastic, and then you just go through so much cologne. But also for all liquid perfumes that you spray on, the actual fragrance is hosted in alcohol. And when you spray that like on your neck, it's gonna get on your face, and alcohol on the face is very drying. So it's not the best for your skin. So that's why when you get like a wax-based cologne or a solid cologne, it doesn't have that alcohol because it's just the fragrance in some wax. So I've honestly been really liking it. This is one from Ulio and Jack. There's a ton of different brands that make solid cologne, so definitely check that out because I recently found out that was an actual thing. If you guys have any like recommendations or brands that you really enjoy, let me know. Also, it's sick that it comes in like this tiny little tin packaging. But yeah, that is a recent discovery that I'm really excited about. And then lastly, in the outermost compartment, we have got Jasper's poop bags because it's the worst when you're out walking your dog and you're like, oh shit, I don't have any more poop bags. And you just feel like the absolute worst person in the world for leaving your dog's poop. Mind you, that has only happened once in Jasper's entire lifetime. Always carry extra poop bags, so I have them in my fanny pack. And that is what's in my fanny pack. Next up, I'm gonna be showing you guys how I actually rock my fanny pack because, you know, for a long time, I was just debating, can I pull off a fanny pack? But honestly, it's all about confidence. If you're confident and you rock your fanny pack, then everyone else is gonna think, damn, look at that guy with his fanny pack. He must be so confident to have a fanny pack. Yeah, guys, it is so nice to just grab your fanny pack and be good to go and just know that you have everything with you. That's why girls have purses. Why is it socially not acceptable for guys to have purses? It is very functional. Everything is in one little pouch. Just grab it, lug it over your shoulder, and then you're good to go. And also, just a quick little update on the Oliver Cabells. I've been wearing the low ones for just over a month now. This is what they are looking like. As you guys can see, still very clean. They've got a tiny little bit of creasing in them because they are leather shoes and your foot moves, so it is natural for your shoes to crease. I personally don't like white shoes that are like perfectly white and perfectly creaseless. I just like my shoes a little bit worn in. So yeah, these are what the low ones look like. But they also recently sent me the Court, and oh, guys, I cannot, which one do you prefer? The Courts definitely are like chunkier, more casual, definitely like Air Force One inspired. The low ones, a little bit more slick, slim, minimal, but guys, these Courts, I've worn them yesterday and they are so, so nice. Both of them are super, super comfy, but it's nice that I have two pairs of white shoes now so that I can just alternate the days that I'm wearing. But yeah, just check out these bad boys. Ooh, so nice. Anyways, let's get to the fits. All right, guys, so that's pretty much it for this video. Those are some of my everyday carries, as well as what is in my fanny pack. If you're a guy and you were just very hesitant about getting a fanny pack because you were scared of what other people were gonna think of you, just get it. Don't worry about what people are gonna think about you. It's so functional, it's practical. Plus, the way it like separates your chesticles makes your pecs look so bomb. And that, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, and remember to be less shitty. Thanks, guys.